and welcome back everyone to my channel. Okay, if you've been following the different videos I put out, I put all different videos out. I have scale videos, I have beginner instrument videos, I have a lot of instructional videos, okay, and I even have some choir warm-up videos. Today's going to be the first in a new set of videos. I recently came into a collection of home movies from when I was younger. And I have many performances from the time I started playing an instrument in fifth grade all the way through high school. I have tons and tons of performances. So I thought, since I teach sixth, seventh, and eighth grade, I thought I'd share my sixth grade piano recital video with you, okay? So we're gonna watch it together, and then I'm gonna critique. I have both pieces up here, okay? Make sure you watch the entire piano recital because it's really good at the end. Okay, and this is the first time I'm going to ask for this, but I would, if you do enjoy this video, hit the like button, because if I get so many likes, then I will make another video. All right, if you want to see a specific video, you can always comment below. I have piano recitals, I have high school performances, I have singing, I have all different performances, so you let me know what you'd like to see. Okay, and I just appreciate you watching this. So today I'm going to be playing two songs as a sixth grade student. I guess I was 12 years old at the time in June. And you'll see the date on there. And we're going to watch it together. And then I'll have some feedback. So, okay, here we go. All right, here I am. Getting ready with my nice haircut, sitting at the piano. Now, I don't take a lot of time to start. So you'll see I sit down, I get right to work, and the first piece I'm playing is Minuet in G major by Beethoven. Good start. Yikes. Repeat. The second time. Repeating again. Feel like the slurs are not very smooth, okay, but rhythmically the dotted eighth 16ths are actually played pretty accurately. I love octaves in the left hand, as you can hear. This is pretty smooth. Good right hand. Yikes. All right, moving forward. The second time is going to be better when it repeats, but it is not necessarily better. All right, we get another chance at the top. Okay, a little blip there in the video. All right, good job. I feel like I'm gonna talk about the ending in a bit, but here comes the second piece. This is the Romanze by Beethoven, 6-8. And repeating. Good 6-8. Yeah, so here's the surprise. There's my dad, coaching T-ball. Hi, Dad. All right, and we are Done with that video. All right. So as you could see, even though I did two songs in the piano recital, you only got to see, I would say, 1.1 songs, because that second song you did not get to see a lot. But for my second piano recital, just to give you a little background, I played piano starting in fifth grade, so this was my second piano recital. I had about 2 years of practice. I played two Beethoven pieces. I thought they were pretty good. And a lot of the stuff I'm going to be saying in this video is stuff I tell my own students, so I'm actually telling my younger self many, many years ago. We have lots of slur markings, okay? And as I play through this, I'm going to be putting some music on the bottom like I did for my video. I thought, overall, I did a decent job playing the slurs, especially in the beginning when I went... Oh, I didn't even slur that. And then this was a little bit not as slurred. I probably didn't use as much pedal back then. All right, and overall, when I watch most of my videos, I'm always heavy on the left hand. So the left hand needs to be nice and light. D. G. Okay, and that will just make it smoother when you put it together. So that was the first section. I obviously go through it two times in the beginning, and when I go back to the beginning, I don't take the repeats. I play it three times. The second section was where I really didn't play those slurs, okay? Now you need to be able to, with your right hand, you need it pretty wide to get G, D, G, to get these intervals played correctly. They're not full chords, but they are open. I guess it would help if I didn't play C sharp there. Now those octaves in the bass, that's really nice, especially this the last time when you play it through the third time at the end, going to the fine. Okay, since we're close to the fine, I know we're going to go through the trio. What could I have done at the end of the piece instead of what I did do? I think I finished with, I'll play the last. And then I just like stop. I just kind of like let it go. All right, you want to bring that last note out, and you want the audience to know you're coming to a resolve the last few measures. Now, I typically play a note lower. Okay, and then you want to release together with both hands. Now, they have the last note by itself. So I'm not sure how your piano teacher would tell you to do it, but I obviously, if I could go back, I know my teacher probably told me all of this stuff. Sorry, Mrs. Tim. But hopefully you can benefit from some of this. Now, the trio was nice and, for the most part, the first time through, the trio was nice and smooth, my right hand. Okay, the issue was trying to combine the hands together. That bass line, each of the beginning of the measures, it starts on G, the next measure starts on C, then the next measure starts on a B. Those are your checkpoints as you go through. One, two, three, C, B, F sharp, G. Okay, and that needs to be smooth as you play along together with the trio. So I've only practiced this piece for about 10 minutes before doing this video, but for the most part, I can get it smooth and work on that, and I obviously would practice. Now, a big part about the trio is it does get softer. I felt like I was a little softer. That piano, for the piano recital, we always go to the same church and do the piano recital. The keys were always heavy It was a baby grand, which I wasn't used to playing on. The keys were like heavy and wooden. So, and it was always super hot there. I don't remember them having air conditioning. You see people fanning themselves with the piano recital program. All right, the next part I really enjoyed right when I started playing it here. You could tell I enjoyed that playing in the part. I think the first time I was much better than the second time. But once the bass comes in on the bottom line, okay, and I always try to, when I play naturally, I'll put a little retardando at the end of each phrase. Obviously, when I was a kid, I was just, let's get through this. Maybe I was nervous. I was like, just got to get through it. And I would go. And I would just kind of rush through it. And then when you get to the end, and it goes right back to the beginning, I just kind of charge ahead. I'm just running, but I would ease back a little bit. So I wouldn't, the audience isn't going to clap until you're fully done. So even if you pause for a second, have your hands up there. All right. And when I take a breath, I move my hands to kind of start. That's just what I do. So that would let them know that you're still going on. And then you want to finish strong. I'm just going to go to the last few measures in the third line. Okay, and that's the way I would end it. I put a little more retardando for the last time. Okay, I don't know if that would make Beethoven proud, but I enjoyed this piece. I always remember playing this piece as a kid. Now, the second piece, I'm going to be honest, this Romanze. I looked up what this piece is. A Romanze is a short instrumental piece of song-like character. Okay, so Beethoven wrote this. Sonatina in G major. There's the sonata, and the sonatina is usually a little bit easier version of a sonata. It's not as long. And this piece, very, very great piece in 6-8. I'm very proud of my 6th grade self that I was able to rock this 6-8, and I even put a few grace notes in there. Oh, I almost got it. Oh, man. And as you saw, unfortunately, the second time when I repeat that, my dad pops in there coaching T-ball. So obviously, whoever was in charge of recording recorded over my piano recital. And out of all my piano recital videos, I don't have them all, but the one I really wanted was recorded over too, or maybe it was never recorded. So, but the next phrase, I'll pull that up on the screen just so you can see. Really, really nice. Another grace note. And then it goes up. Okay, so it has a really, really good 6-8 feel. I've always enjoyed teaching 6-8, and now seeing myself as a 6th grade student rocking the 6-8 on the piano, now I know why I enjoy it so much. Returns back to the theme that you heard earlier in that little snippet of the piano recital video. So good job to me getting through both these pieces. All right, I put links below to where you can get the free sheet music using a website I call MuseScore. Okay, both great if you play piano or if you're interested. Okay, they're not beginner pieces, okay? I'd only been playing 2 years at this point, so I'm surprised I was able to play this. I did know I picked it up pretty quick. I started saxophone in the 4th grade, and then I started piano in 5th grade, and then slowly but surely I played a bunch of other things as I went along. But hopefully you enjoyed watching this throwback video. All right, I have lots of footage. Like I said, hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. Okay, hopefully you'll watch some of my other videos. If you need some instrumental, help working on your different parts for different songs, okay? I have lots of videos now, so I hope you enjoy the rest of your day, and happy practicing if you're working on your instrument.